Good morning and welcome. Good morning. Well, in the last 60 days, I have been in a tornado in Oklahoma about a week before I left. I've now had an earthquake and a hurricane. But you know, I was saying to somebody this morning, nothing compares to this day, which is the first day of school every single year. Mr. Bird and I were talking about this morning how exciting it is just to be starting another brand new school year. And our quintet was supposed to be popping back out here so that we could give them another round of applause. They worked in the summer to prepare for you today, and also a huge round of applause for Mary Jo for working with the students, which was great. Come on out. I think a standing, that's pretty awesome that high school students will work in the summer. Great job. Thank you very much, and we appreciate you giving up time in your summer to prepare for us today. This is why we're here. It's for our students. And we also, I don't know if you can, oh, you can see it above my head. The Twitter feed is running, so we are encouraging cell phone use. It's okay to pull them out. And it started actually over the weekend, and thanks to John Brett for that, just kind of a little bit of fun. I also have some very special guests that I would like to recognize this morning. Susan Ehrman from the GM, PTA, PTSA. Claire Waters from the Band Boosters. I know she's here somewhere. Donna Englander with the Foundation. And I don't think our representatives could be here today, but I want to say thank you to them because they are also sponsors for us today. Elementary PTA, MEH PTA, and also our athletic boosters. We are welcoming Lawrence Webb and Mr. Ira Kalin from the City Council. If you'll stand up and just let us applaud you. We have two school board members with us today. Kieran Sharp, I believe, is back in the back. Oh, he had to go to work. Okay. And also, Pat Rickards is here as well today with us. Our Falls Church city manager, and I have to say publicly, thank you to Mr. Wyatt Shields for helping us over these last two Falls Church City difficult, stormy weather. Without his support, it's very hard to check the buildings. So thank you, Mr. Wyatt Shields, for joining us this morning. And I had the pleasure this morning of meeting two of our Falls Church City founders, and Mr. Lou Olam, who I believe is right in the back. I can't see very well with the lights. Very back. And Mrs. Jessie Thackeray is also with us. What a wonderful, wonderful morning. We are also lucky today to have Monica Gomez with us. She is from the Pathway to Baccalaureate. It's a brand new program that we're starting at GM. If you want to stand up, because GM staff, she'll be there once a week in your building. At this time, I know that Mr. Mike Palmrose is going to share with us a little video clip because, as you know, our message today is Little City, Wide World. And I really don't think there is any school district in the country, I know that there is not, that has the diversity and the excitement that we have on an international level. So let's see what they've put together for us.
Ciao.
Selamat pagi, apa kabar?
Ni hao.
Bonjour, comment estás? It's a little Spanish too.
Selamat pagi, apa kabar?
Manaon.
Namaste.
Bonjour, comment ça va?
Chào buổi sáng.
Namaste.
Dear Gwich.
Guten Tag, wie geht's?
Ni hao. Ni hao.
Hola.
Aloha.
Salam andamana andamanash.
Annyeonghaseyo.
Annyeonghaseyo.
Hello.
Hola, ¿cómo te va?
Salmalu.
Bon dia.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Merhaba.
Привет, как дела?
Ni hao.
Mabuhay.
Hello.
Buenos dias.
¿Cómo están?
Chia.
Ni hao.
Dobranku, jak sprawy?
Bienvenidos al año escolar 2011-2012. Y yo hablo español.
And those are not all of the languages represented in our school district. That's pretty fantastic. And I'm just going to add, you know, Mary Beth said you can say hello in another language, and some of you know I'm a dual passport carrying family, so I'll say g'day from Australia. My husband's an Aussie. And then I said I do know Pig Latin because I grew up in Oklahoma, so Elohe is Pig Latin. Now it's time. I'm going to invite Ira Kalin to come and say a few words on behalf of the City Council.
Bienvenidos a todos. Espero que tenemos un año exitosísimo. That's about the limit of my Spanish at the moment. Thank you for the opportunity to participate in today's convocation. I imagine that you are most anxious to get to your classrooms and prepare for the upcoming school opening in just a few days. In that vein, I'll keep my comments brief to a few thousand words. Just kidding. So not to worry about that. I believe I speak for the City Council when I say that we appreciate the hard work, dedication, and professionalism that have been and no doubt will continue to characterize the quality of our teaching staff. The appreciation of the high standards and performance is genuine and widespread. The value of the city's educational programs are well known and well described in other fora, so I won't repeat them right now. There is consensus that the schools are a priority for the city and that the future success of the schools is synonymous with the success of the city. There is not, however, a single view as to what actions need to be taken now to ensure the long-term sustainability and growth of our educational program. In that regard, we expect that the upcoming school board City Council discussions will be robust and productive. Irrespective of apparent differences, it is critical, I repeat, it is critical that you understand that we are all on the same page as to our support for our teachers and our students. I wish you, teachers and school employees, above all, to have a rewarding year and to the extent possible, have some fun. Thank you very much.
And thank you again, Mr. Kalin. And we are looking forward to a great working relationship with the city. And I would just want to add that I actually live in Falls Church City with 100 of our students at Pearson Square. So I'm fully invested in the city and excited. Next, I'd like to invite Mr. Pat Rickards, who is our chair of our school board this year.
Good morning. Oh, come on, a room full of educators, and that's what I get? Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. Well, I want to thank you all for coming. I want to thank you all for being part of the Falls Church City Public Schools family. For those of you who had to listen to me last week, those new teachers that we welcomed, some of this may be a little familiar, but a lot of it isn't. So we're here this morning talking about this notion of little city and wide world. And for those who don't know, I actually do education in my day job. And so when we talk about the world and we talk about international, it's always hard not to get into the statistics and how do we compare. And so when I'm out talking about Falls Church City public schools around the country, I automatically fall back on the statistics that I think everybody in this community and everybody in this room should be very proud of. You know, that's the notion, you know, Washington Post has us as the top school district in the greater Washington area. The state of Virginia has us with the top graduation rates and SAT scores in the state. And as Dr. Jones has reported to us, when we look at our international baccalaureate program and you compare us to 21,000 other schools that are doing IB, right now we rank 11th. Of the 10 ahead of us, 9 of them are magnet schools that only take the students they want to take. So that's pretty impressive for what we do. But at the end of the day, statistics are statistics, and we can make them say whatever we want them to say. Ultimately, the measure of Falls Church City Public Schools is all of you. It's the men and women who are sitting in this room. It's all of the educators. And by educators, I mean the teachers, the counselors, the secretaries, the maintenance staff, facilities, everybody who make Falls Church City Public Schools what it is. You are why we are successful. You are the ones we entrust our children to. And I say that as a parent who come Tuesday am bringing my oldest son to Mount Daniel for the first time. So please bear with Michael, for those of you who are going to be dealing with him. He's a great kid, but he's got a lot of energy. But on behalf of Falls Church City School Board, I want to thank all of you for being with us here. As I told the incoming teachers, we have what's called the Falls Church Way in this city. And it means that we have a greater level of involvement than most are used to seeing in other cities and other school districts. It's a good thing. It's something we all should embrace. The fact that every resident of this city cares so much about public education in Falls Church. The fact that every resident wants to be involved, wants to be helpful, wants to better understand what's happening in your school building, in your classroom, can be a good thing. And I say can. I recognize sometimes it's not so much. But it can be a good thing. And so I ask, as we're going into this year, we are all in this together. And I hope that you all see that as a school board, we're in this with you. As a community, we are in this with you. We all want to see success. We all want to see achievement. And I mean that both in terms of our student test scores, but also in terms of you all individually. As some of you may know, the state is having us put new teacher evaluation program into place. We want to see you all succeed. We know you all can succeed because we see it every day. We see it in our kids. We see it in our schools. And so I am just thrilled that you all are here. I'm thrilled that you've decided to come back to be a part of Falls Church Public Schools this year. And I hope that we will continue to see you for years and years to come. And this is going to be a terrific year. And so I thank you and welcome again to the 2011-2012 school year.
And I just want to speak very, very quickly to say that not all school boards are like the school board in Falls Church City. They are really focused on academics. And I can't tell you, I come from football country in Oklahoma, and not all our school districts are as focused on academics as they should be. And last year when I was going through the interview process, it was so refreshing just watching school board meetings. They really want that whole child development, not only the arts, music, but academics is very important here. And what amazed me is we still have award-winning athletic programs. You're great at everything. And so we appreciate that. And that takes hours and hours and hours of their volunteer work. And so, again, thank you to our school board. Our vice chair, Susan Kearney, just came in, so she is our vice chair this year. But thank you to our school board. And next, John Pepper is going to come forward on behalf of PEAK.
Morning. Thank you to our city council member and fantastic school board chair, Pat Rickards, for just an amazing speech. I'm actually not here on behalf of PEAK, kind of. I'm here on behalf of the Falls Church City Education Association. And on behalf of the association, I want to welcome you to the 2011-2012 school year. During the past school year, we celebrated the successes of our students and our community. Like was just said, we had outstanding scores in SOL exams. We had outstanding scores on standardized tests. We had state championships in sports and academics. Jamie Sharp, I didn't forget about you. We had tournament runs and other things. Everything we did was outstanding, and it would not have been possible and will continue to not be possible without the contributions of each and every person sitting in this room. So together, we continue to rise to these challenges of high expectations. And I am positive that this year will be no different despite any of the changes and new challenges, like working in a construction zone, maybe TJ, or changes in building and district level leadership. I encourage you to embrace these challenges head on, to learn from them, and to be even better every day than you were the day before, although in Falls Church, I'm not even sure how that's possible because you guys are all so outstanding. Our success, of course, would not be possible without the commitment of education provided by our school board and our city council. Having sat in on more budget and other meetings than I can ever care to remember for the rest of my life, I know the job they have is extremely difficult. So once again, I just want to thank the school board and city council for their commitment to education in this community. It's truly outstanding. As always, I wish you the best of luck for an outstanding 2011-2012 school year. If at any time throughout the year you have any questions, comments, concerns, please feel free to bring it to my attention, bring it to the attention of any of the building reps. The association has been and will always continue to be there for you. Our doors and our ears are always open. So thank you very much. Have a tremendous school year and enjoy the rest of your day.
As you know, we really wanted to have student focus this morning because that's why we all do what we do, because we love kids. And we're welcoming Rand Walter and Nate Cooper, who have an original composition of Jack and Jill this morning.
Hi, welcome back to school. Yeah, school.
Welcome back yourself.
Just kidding. I'm Rand, this is Nate, and we're gonna play a song for you today that I wrote called Jack and Jill, so enjoy.
Sitting on his porch, he said, I'd like to travel. I've gotten out of touch with the world all around me. So he said, I'm gonna go right now. Once there was a girl who said, I wanna leave, to leave this town behind me and see what's in store for me and the world all around me. So she said, I'm gonna go right now. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go right now. Oh, I know I'm gonna go.
Train to little city was crowded once again. When the passengers got on, just a single seat was left for the girl from that small town who had said, I'm gonna go right now. Sat down in her seat, she gave a grin when he flashed her a smile and offered her a drink. She said, that's mighty kind of you, sir. My name is Jill, what's yours? He said, my name is Jack, and I hope that we don't find out that our luck's the same as Jack and Jill. Anyway, not until we've grown old together. You see, I think that I've caught case of love at first sight. He'll never go. He'll never go. Oh, I know he'll never go. Ah, I think I've caught a case of love, best thing I ever got. I think I've caught a case of love, best thing I ever got.
Wow. And thanks to Rand and Nate. And again, that just shows the level of talent that we have in our school division. It's amazing. Is one of the newest employees here. This is really fun for me because we are getting ready to recognize people who have been in the district for a very long time. And Lisa High is coming to the stage to join me. And in your program, you will see those people who've served 5 years and 10 years, and they are actually recognized at their school site. So at this time, if we could ask those who have served 15 years just to come and join me on stage. Okay, I'm going to read the names. I know we're trying to find our program. Tammy Chinchek. Jose Fuentes. Tim Guy. Tom Horn. We're going to make a big line across the front before you exit the other side. Rick Jowers. Peggy Payne. Chris Pacrolidis, Mr. P. Helen Tam. Alice Tam Lee. And Pam Wilkie. And again, these are 15-year employees. Awesome. And next, we're going to ask our 20-year employees to come to the stage. 20 years. That's a long time. Sarah Blake. Sita Chansenbat. Bridget Dean Pratt. Yolanda Jordan. And Eduardo Molina. These are our 20-year employees. Amazing. And next, we have three people who've been in this district for 25 years. Wow. Marco De Las Casas. Mary Kelly. And Janet Weber. Thank you. 25 years for all three of those. 25. That's amazing. And, you know, many, many, many educators never had the opportunity to even stay in the profession for 30 years. But we are actually recognizing two people today who have 30 years in Falls Church City Public Schools. I'm going to ask John Ballew to come to the stage. And joining him on stage is Ann Gordon. And at this time, I understand that John Ballew is usually behind the scenes. I've already figured that out with all the setup he did even for today. But he is actually going to come forward and say a few words.
Hello. Greetings to all you newbies. Anyhow, last week in the Sunday Post, there was an article about the National Zoo. And they were saying how regrettable it looks so much like the 80s. And as a full-fledged baby boomer, I guess that pegs me pretty well. But in 1981, I was one of two finalists to redesign that reptile house. And I lost the job, the other candidate won, and I looked for another position, and GM High School, Middle School at the time, was offering a part-time paraprofessional position with art credentials, and it seemed like a temporary alternative. So I came to the interview and fell in love with this auditorium. You know, I'd never planned a career in education, but I've been, oh, there's my phone, right on time. But I was looking for work that allowed me to wear a lot of hats, and this place fit the bill. I couldn't have worked in a better place for that matter. But I do wonder how 80s I still come across. So instead of a career in design, I fell in with a crowd of first-class educators. Whoa. That's for long distance. We'll have to see what that one's all about. So this is a chance for me to recognize some very, very important people who influenced me early on and who've moved on to other things in many ways. I really want to give a hats off to Nancy Sprague, who really kept me on the straight and narrow in the first years, and George Tomes, who had the beard and the spirit of Walt Whitman. Bob Snee, who believed in giving teachers a long leash, especially me. Mary Lee Tatum, who was a national spokesperson for family life and sex education. She always made me... They're persistent. We'll just turn it off. Kay Wyatt, who loved storytelling, and Michael Hoover, who always valued what I did around here. These are very important people to me. And my wife, who taught in the middle school here for 24 years. She and I are the only married couple to both have won the Agnes Meyer Awards, but she won the very first year they gave those out, so she's got precedence. All three of my children have come through the school system here. I can't say enough how, important it's been for all the people who've supported me and, made me feel such a part of this whole community. I want to thank my department, Fine Arts Department, who supported me in a lot of things that we've done in this room. I've worked with some terrific people on this stage. We've seen thousands of students perform here. We've built sets for so many shows that I forget what we've produced. Generations of students helped me take this place apart and put it back together again. And this is just, a significant place to be. It was a great workshop for education. Incidentally, we're still famous on YouTube for a short video called When Robots Attack. Took place right here in the middle of the floor. So if you're looking for a site here that refers to our school, that's a good one. Anyhow, I wanted to thank you all for recognizing my longevity in a world that reinvents itself on a regular basis. It all tends to blur together, as it should for the sake of the new students who come here every year. I have been privileged to witness all the changes and all the major events, all the triumphs and tribulations that have occurred. And I can't say what a satisfying career it's been. The stage is ready for a new year. I believe this is some of the best experiences we can provide kids in our school system. And even after 30 years, I'm getting ready to get started.
And we are going to invite Anne to come forward and share a few words.
I'm not very good at math, so I didn't realize I was getting this today, but I did want to share a little city, small world story. This summer, I was in Peru for 18 days. On my third day in the Peruvian Amazon, I met a woman who turned out she lived in Falls Church from 1979 to 1983 and had taken my parenting class in the early 80s. The next day, I met a woman from Fairfax who is a physical therapist who I had met 25 years ago when she was working with one of my students. She knows many people here and has worked with many of our students. So I guess the moral of the story is if you stick around here long enough, you can travel anywhere in the world and find people from Falls Church City.
Thank you, John and Ann. That's wonderful. 30 years. That's amazing. We have a big, exciting year ahead of us. At TJ and Mount Daniel, they'll both be going through their PYP process. We have the Pathway to Baccalaureate program at GM. But I also, we are a very, very busy place in this summer. And I just out of curiosity, if you worked with an enrichment class this summer or you taught summer school, would you stand up just so we can say thank you for keeping our doors open and open for kids in the summer? And along with that, when our buildings are full of children, we also have buses that run. We have people that are keeping our buildings clean. We have facilities management. Would all of those people stand up? Because we could not offer these programs in the summer without your assistance. Most of them are way back in the back. We also have a lot of teachers who have done exciting things, and I know there are many, many more than these are just a few that somebody has shared with us at the central office. Renata went to Uruguay, and Maria Shields traveled to Turkey. We also had Brad Lance in MEH, and I do think we need Brad to stand up because he was one of 50 educators to attend the STEM Institute, and there were thousands across the country that applied for that. So Brad Lance, if you'd stand up and just let us say congratulations. Awesome. We also have, when you see some of you, if you've been through the national board process or if you've watched people go through that, it's not an easy process. And this is the largest group that we have experienced in Falls Church City is this year for one group that are going through national board certification together. If you are in pursuit of national board certification, would you stand up, please, so that everybody will know who you are so they can give you support this year? And I'd also like to add, in order to help them with those people who are nationally board certified, would you stand up so we can say congratulations and so they'll know your face and those people that they need to go and knock on your door. We also are joining six staff who have become certs. Michelle Harcharik, if you would stand up, please. She will be the 5'7 reading cert. Gwen Villarreal will be our K-12 ESOL cert this year. Phyllis Kravinsky, the K-1 language arts cert. Amanda Blanchard, 5'7 through 7 math cert. Allison Moriarty, 5-7, special education cert. And Jenny York, 8-12, special education cert. And next, we're going to recognize some people who are either new to the district or they are under a new title. And I'm just going to start out by introducing a couple of people who have changed their roles a little bit this summer, or they may be new to the district at the division level. John Wesley Brett has a new title as our digital communications and our Twitter expert. So where's John? Stand up, John, if you would. I know you're... He told me people often think that he is the division photographer. And I will say, before I came here, I was so amazed that he puts out that newsletter every single morning. That is amazing. We are welcoming Davida Gaudette Easton as our HR specialist at Central Office. Davida, so when you need help with all that good stuff. Elaine Harrington is joining us as a social work intern. Elaine, I'm not sure if she's here this morning. Okay. We're welcoming a chief technology director, kind of a title change, and does a fantastic job even during the weekend, making sure our email stayed up this weekend when it went down with a hurricane. Rick Jowers. And this next person, I know Central Office was excited to see her sit at that desk because they went without that greeter at the door sitting there. Cynthia Latimer is joining Central Office. Molly Narbaugh has a new title as Program Specialist in addition to being the CIA Secretary and helping Dr. Guba. So congratulations, Molly. We have a new title for another one of our tech masters in the district, and I know that you'll know who he is because he runs around and fixes everything for us, Dang Nguyen. He is an engineer. We're welcoming Robert Ronco as a bus driver for us. Lisa Rosenbaum as a psychology intern. She's right back here. And we're welcoming Nikki Wise-Miller in food service. And last but not least, we do have a brand new principal in the district. Saida Ashahid will be leading our middle school. And at this time, and I have to say, this is the only school I've ever known that has a purple hippo, and I think that's wonderful. I'm going to turn it over to Kathy Haleko.
Well, Danny and I had a great summer, did we not? Yes, we did. And we send greetings to all of you from Mount Daniel. Welcome back. As you have heard, we have a big year coming up with our PYP verification. And we have many new faces to welcome to Mount Daniel this year, and a few people who have changed jobs. So when I call your name, if you would stand, and then we'll hold applause until the end. Thank you. Kim Aubrey, preschool teacher. Samantha Beam, first grade para. Erica Bean, outdoor classroom para. Christina Brooks, special education and first grade para. Kelly Flynn, kindergarten para. Beth Green, PYP coordinator. Bit Harper, kindergarten teacher. John Pettis, instructional technology teacher. Jeannie Puentes, secretary. Gisela Schneider, special ed para. Karen Schools, school health aide. And Esty Sherwin, occupational therapy. Congratulations to all of you and welcome. Thank you, Dan. And next we have Bob Palermo from TJ to read and let you know who's coming to TJ. Thank you, Dan.
Morning, everybody. It's great to see some of my friends and colleagues from the other building this morning. And I would like to welcome our new employees. We're glad they're joining our TJ Tiger team at TJ. And like Mount Daniel, we're excited about the PYP certification process, and construction at TJ will be exciting as well. Our new employees, I would like you also to stand and please hold your applause until the end. Silvia Argueta Recenos, custodian. Jill Ernst, reading specialist, comes to us from Hawaii. Mbang Ekpime comes to us from George Mason, and she'll be a paraprofessional. Kelly Marple, who finished the school year last year for us as a filling in at third grade, will teach third grade this year as well. Robin Plata, second grade teacher, comes to us from Mount Daniel also. Kate Sesh will be an ESOL teacher, and some of you certainly know her from her time in, at Central Office. Lauren Washington, special education paraprofessional. We welcome all of you to our TJ team, and really glad that you're going to join us. And at this time, I welcome Saida Ashahid up on stage to introduce the MEH folks.
Since I'm a Husky, they've heard me howl already. So we like to do a woo-hoo! Thank you. The mediocre teacher tells. The good teacher explains. The superior teacher demonstrates. The great teacher inspires. Who will you inspire this year? I am so proud and excited to be here at Falls Church. At MEHS, we harbor high expectations for all. This year, we will continue our international focus as we explore the MYP program. I ask that our new employees please stand and please hold your applause. We have several new to the division and changing jobs. From one location to the next. Christy Amato, special education teacher. Amy Burling, special education teacher. Tori Fay, sixth grade teacher. Alicia Garrison, attendance secretary. Michelle Hakarik, reading teacher. Alyssa Jacobson, guidance counselor. Michelle Janney, seventh grade math teacher. Valerie Kirby, school health aide. Brad Lands, tech ed teacher. Kimberly Lewis, Spanish teacher. Marlea Liebner, special education paraprofessional. Jeremy Lowe, fifth grade teacher. Najla Muhammad, guidance secretary, and that might be changing soon. Margaret Sava, special education paraprofessional, and Amber South, seventh grade math teacher. Can we give them a round of applause? Thank you. And at this time, I have the distinct honor and pleasure of introducing Mr. Ty Bird, the principal of GM George Mason High School.
Tell you what, never ends. Welcome back, everyone. Looking forward to an exciting school year at George Mason High School, where we have the most talented, engaging, charismatic, and enthusiastic faculty in the entire universe. Again, I'll follow along with my colleagues. I'm going to invite our new people to stand up and ask you to hold your applause until we finish reading the entire list. Mo Smith, who comes to us from the middle school, she's going to be in our mathematics department. Angela Westing, a new English teacher for us. Holly Garcia in Spanish. Kari Lynn Summers, special education. Heather Richardson, counseling secretary. Monica Gomez, pathways to baccalaureate. Dr. Dana Wiseman, chemistry. Peter Laub, English, who graduated from George Mason High School years ago. Did you have Mr. Ballou? Some people who are not so new to our school but are new positions. Erica Simmons is now a full-time mathematics teacher with us. Steve Knight, new to George Mason but not new to Falls Church City Public Schools. He's our technology coordinator. Mr. Ben Schwartz, who's with our ESOL program. He was with us last year. He's now with us in a greater capacity. Mr. Chris Carrico, who's been with us as a coach and a paraprofessional for years and is now a full-time special education teacher. And Ms. Stefania Odaleta, who is a special education paraprofessional. And I'm sorry, who am I missing? Oh, and Pam Mahoney switched positions as well. She is no longer a special education teacher. She's now in our social studies department. So give them a big round of applause. Okay. One more. I'm sorry. Ms. Sally Larish, if you would stand. We now have a full-time reading specialist at George Mason High School, and Sally Larish is going to do that. Before I invite Dr. Jones back up, I'd like to take this moment to thank all of our colleagues at the other schools, Mount Daniel, TJ, and also Mary Ellen Henderson Middle School. We have the distinct pleasure every year of celebrating our students as they graduate and they walk across the stage at Constitution Hall, and we get a standing ovation from all their parents and their guardians, but we realize that we're only a small part of that team. That journey begins at Mount Daniel as they bounce through the hallways and Kathy Haleko's amazing staff there, and it continues on as they strut across the stage at Constitution Hall ready to compete in the environment and the global economy. So thank you for all you do to help our kids get ready, Rand and Nate. Those kids, they benefit from your talents and your support as well. So thank you for all you do. Have a great school year. Dr. Jones. Well done.
Just one more time, I want to thank our sponsors because it's amazing that they actually pull together and are able to put on the breakfast. And not only did Richard Kane's food service group do an outstanding job, and I might add he had Diet Coke. I don't know where Richard is, but that was wonderful. That was an addition. We do want to say thank you again to our PTAs, PTSA, George Mason Elementary, MEH, also to the band boosters, our athletic boosters. Again, they support us not only all year, but at events like this. Our Education Foundation, and I would be in trouble if I did not mention that they do have, they're holding the Run for the Schools on September 18th. And it is a 5K run, and I have been assured that it also includes a 1 mile very slow walk. Donna has said that's okay. And every school does have a team, and we are encouraging you to participate because a lot of the technology that you see in your schools is coming from your PTAs and your foundation, and they're working very closely together to support that. I also, being brand new in the division, it would have been a really hard start if I didn't have a lot of support. And our central office, a lot of our central office work all summer. Some of them that really don't work really do. And if I know that I think most of them are sitting together. Would central office, would you stand up? Because you do some wonderful work, and I'm very appreciative of how you've helped me this summer. Thank you. And I do. I am going to pick on one person because, you know, if you've been in education long enough, you know, who do you really go ask the hard questions to? And it's usually somebody in the central office, and sometimes it's not even the superintendent, it's the superintendent's secretary. And I would not know where anything was from the first day that I came without Marty. So, Marty, would you stand up just so we can all say thank you for what you do? And we also have four different groups that worked really hard to pull this off this morning for us. It takes a lot of time and effort, and they start planning very early for this. It's hard to plan a party for hundreds of people. FCCTV, Mike Palmros and his crew, thank you so much. We appreciate what you do. John Ballou for having the stage ready and lights and all of that, and making sure he had to clean up first from a little bit of water and earthquake. So, John, thank you. John Brett for taking pictures and everything that he does for communication for us. And last but not least, I think she might be behind the stage. Is Mary Beth still behind the stage? I just want to take a minute to say, Mary Beth starts working on this like before the year is even over. And she spends literally all summer long. Every lay has to be counted and coordinated by color. And she has to recruit the children for all of the little mascots and all that fun stuff. And Mary Beth, we could not do it without you. And I just wanted to say how much we really appreciate everything that you do for us. And I'm going to close this out this morning because I know you're all excited to get back to your classrooms. And, you know, one question that I get all the time, what are you going to change? What are you going to change? Well, really for me, it's not about me changing anything. It's about us working together and continuing to move forward. Because there's a difference between change for change's sake and continuing to move forward. And anything that we change, we will be changing together because we have a need for it. This summer, Lisa High put in a new application system and it's automated. That's because we needed it. And those people who are new to the division, many of them actually applied through that system. And one of the people that I love to read, and I know our principals have, I think in the class that they're taking this summer in their graduate work, are going to be reading Michael Fullan. And those of you that read Michael Fullan, he talks a lot about change, about how as educators we need to move forward. And he also talks about one of the greatest defeats that we have in education is that we allow our experience to actually hold us back because we always just stick with what we know. And the one challenge that I would have for you this school year is step out, raise the bar for yourself, and that includes me, learn something new. If you couldn't Twitter this morning because you didn't know how, go back and ask a colleague to show you how. I know this weekend, Dr. Gupa was all excited because she bought a brand new Apple laptop because she was inspired at Airlie by Brett Spargrove. We have wonderful resources in our division to learn from one another. So step out of the box, learn something new, and we're going to continue moving forward. Not only are we a little citywide world, but international excellence. We have the kids to do it. More than anywhere in the United States, we know our children truly are going to step into jobs that are global. That's the community that we work with, so we want to prepare them. Have a wonderful year. I cannot wait to get out in your classrooms and visit all of you. So thank you.